West Africa has recently been rocked by military uprisings with over 7 coup d'etats in the past 3 years. These have been occasioned by rogue soldiers who have overthrown the presidents of Mali, that is in August 2020 and May 2021, Guinea September 2021, Burkina Faso January and September 2022, and Chad and recently in Niger, where President Mohamed Bazoum was overthrown by this protection unit. This sweeping wave has sent shivers to politicians across the continent. In this regard, Felix Okot-Ogong, a member of parliament for Dokolo South, who represents Uganda in the Pan-African Parliament, says the African Union must rise to occasion through the African Court of Justice to make it risky for any political force to think of taking power through gun violence.
Serious matter regarding democracy. So as members of Pan-African Parliament, we have debated this matter and we have raised our concern to the African Union that something has to be done, one in terms of those who organize coups, the level of impunity. Our African Court of Justice should step up so that those who change government unconstitutionally are taken on.
Okot and other legislators believe the new wave of coups have been facilitated by weakness of regional bodies like the African Union, ECOWAS, among others, which have proven to be toothless as far as restoration of constitutional order is concerned.
No bodies or federations have to be more powerful than individual member states. Now, what is causing all this? Most of the member states are, in a way, they are autonomous, but also more powerful.
African states should embrace a political system that does not exclude anybody from governance. For example, proportional representation.
Lawmakers are also concerned with a lack of respect to constitutional governance in several countries where dictatorship is taking shape as the new normal.
We have witnessed very many coups in Africa. I think this is mostly to do with political space in various countries. When you try to centralize power within a certain group of people, you expect some people to object to that.
Coups are being carried out because of abuse of a constitution. Those are justifiable. Those coups are justifiable. Whenever you oppress people, they fight back.
As questions the cause of the new wave of constitutions linger in the minds of politicians, neocolonialism has been partly blamed for brewing conflicts in several African countries.
Can people need to start remobilizing the population against colonialism, neocolonialism? There is external influence in these coups and even wars. Wars that are occurring like in East Africa here, in the Congo, even in West Africa. You have seen there were coups before which were allowed.
The East Africa, let us really respect our constitutions. Let us have a just leadership and fairness so that our people, let us give back. Let us try to cater for the economic transformation of our people.
The Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, has taken a hard stance on last week's takeover, the seventh coup in West and Central Africa since 2020, and given Niger's coup leaders until Sunday, which was yesterday, to step down and reinstate the elected president, Mohamed Bazoum, which did not happen. This report has been filed by Fred Kajubi for the news from Parliament.